welcome to another day at Ewetopia Farms. Here's what's happening on the farm today.
You can see why they call this a terminal breed, eh? They are a meat breed, eh? So I wanted to go to a straight Dorset.
Here's our Raven. He's wanting the cat food. Where'd he go?
Right there. There's pigeons up in that ceiling. He wants the eggs.
But he also wants cat food, but Scotty's over the bowl, which the Raven finds really annoying.
She just put the run on him. Pigeon eggs is up in the roof there, in the ceiling.
Yeah.
That's where he's at.
Well, it's natural pigeon control, that's for sure. He went down low again.
He
does have an egg.
Yeah.
He broke it.
Well, at least you get rid of the pigeons for us.
That's right. We were wondering how we were going to control that.
Funny, you got too many pigeons, just get a Raven.
There he goes.
Yeah.
overnight chores here. And just gave the lamb some fresh hay. So basically, I'm rolling out the second cut for the mother sheep, and I just grabbed the core of the bale and rolled out in the feeders here. You can see why they call this a terminal breed, eh? Come on, Max. Yeah, they're packing their back. So I just rolled out some hay on top of these feeders. Some people say, why haven't I cut out one of the bars to make the feed come out easier? And the issue I would have with that is every morning I go in here like this, and I pull out the feed that the grain shows. And if I pulled a bar out, I'm thinking they would have the whole manger for grain all full of hay. It might be worse. So I'm just going to deal with it. But when lambs eat over top of when lambs eat on top like that, it tells you that they're getting the feed an easier way they can pull it out. But see, that's a terminal breed. They're a meat breed, eh? Anyways, I'm just doing chores here, so I'm just looking at all the little fellas eating some hay here. What do you got there, buddy? So, believe it or not, that's a female sheep right there. Whoa, it's a big one. But yeah, this is a terminal breed. This breed here, you see, this is why I wanted to go. We had crosses called Dordos, we called them. They were 50-50 cross, and I didn't think they had enough meat, so I wanted to go to a straight Dorset. And you can see the Dorsets are a little more chunkier. Maybe not quite as many lambs, but I think Lynn says we're running 1.7, 1.8 on the Dorsets. Pretty happy with that. This is a little ram lamb I'm looking at right now. That first one right there. 68. See, his legs are set perfect underneath him. So I'm looking pretty heavily on that one to hold that one back. See how well he's standing on his legs? Good spread in the front feet. And see the rear legs? I'm gonna get behind him, he's gonna run away. But I think that 68 right there, that's one of my keepers. I like him a lot. He's got the wrinkles and he's got the right head and everything. Hey, buddy. Remember that number, 68. Because if you come to the farm, you can't have him. Well, actually, I'll let him go for the right money. But I'm thinking he's above average. Hey, buddy. See, he's got a good... he's got a good deep rib on him. Hey, Bob. I think his legs are well placed at the back. Come on, Fuzzy. Oh, this is my little Fuzzy lamb with the open wool. God, could you keep yourself a little cleaner than that, right? But I think that's probably one of the top 10 lambs in this group right now. 68. Well, there's a real good female. Oh, that's Lynn's. That's Lynn's lamb. Hey, buddies. Oh, who are you? Is Mr. Killer. A lot of these lambs are Hannibal's lambs. You can tell they're a little shorter, a little stockier. That's a Hannibal lamb right there. Be nice, Max, hey? Anyways, I better keep going. It's 5 o'clock and I'm doing chores. This whole group of lambs left today. And we already have 4 ewes already in here already. These are all Suffolk, so they're gonna have to go to the cover all shortly. But it's really winding down right now, so hopefully shortly there'll be no more baby lambs. Sorry about that. And we'll only be raising sheep at that point. So hopefully you're gonna keep watching us. Talk to you shortly.
We have the air roaring on the corn right now because it's a warm day and we don't want the corn to mold and the bin back there, so that's what all that noise is. Anyway, we were tired today, so we did a lot of videos and just let the camera roll so you could see what it's actually really like here with not too much commentary and just seeing how the sheep react when Arnie's feeding them and while they're waiting to be fed and stuff like that. There's actually mosquitoes. Like, it's so weird again, the weather. It's boiling hot. And it's the beginning of March. It should be snow on the ground. And I know we don't like snow, but this is really probably a bad omen. Anyway, thanks for joining us. Please be sure to join us again tomorrow for the next episode at Ewetopia Farms. Bye for now.